evening. You're watching Spotlight. I'm Palki Sharma Upadhyay. A day after the Bengaluru police arrested four people in connection with the Kammanahali molestation case, another case of sexual and physical assault has been reported in the very same area in the KG Halli police station limits. At 6:30 a.m. on Friday, a 23-year-old woman was walking towards the Arabic College bus stop when a man allegedly started stalking her. He later assaulted her. That's what police sources have told us at this point. And these are images from New Delhi after the horrifying CCTV video of a girl being molested and the policeman who came to help her also being attacked in the national capital. A spine-chilling incident coming to light from East Delhi, where a Delhi University professor was assaulted by a goon in full public view in broad daylight. What's worse is that not one of the many people who were present came forward to help this woman. Joining me is my colleague Sagai Raj. Sagai, in the very same police station area, another case coming to light thanks to CCTV cameras installed there, where a woman on her way to college was assaulted. Has any action been taken by the police so far?
Small correction, it is not the same police station, it is a different police station. It is KG Halli. The earlier incident was reported at Kammanahali. So it is two different places, Kadugondanahalli and Kammanahali. So the case has been filed in Kadugondanahalli. As I speak to you, I got to hear from the DCP saying that they have filed the case just now. And initially, this girl was reluctant to file any kind of case against the stalker. And now, after this video was emerged on social media and on mainstream media, police have spoken to the victim, and now she has filed a complaint. And she has told that when she was walking, she was completely covered from her toe to her head. She was wearing a hijab. Even then, this stalker followed her up and hugged her and tried to kiss her. And that's when she fought with him, she had hurt her tongue and as well as her feet. Now the case has been filed. The women police officers are taking statements from the victim. And what we get to learn is that the police have already started to hunt for this stalker with some of the CCTV footage which is available in and around in that particular area.
Right. You've been speaking to people, you've been speaking to young women in Bengaluru ever since the New Year's Eve incident came to light. Are they confident that the police is dealing with these cases effectively, that they're giving or taking exemplary action in these cases so that other potential molesters feel deterred?
See, we are getting mixed reactions from the girls here in Bengaluru, because many of them feel it is safe and few of them are scared. And they are not willing to comment on anything on this. In fact, in Kammanahalli case, cops were quick enough to nab the culprits as soon as this video emerged on social media and on mainstream media. If you see, the CCTV footage was shared when the video was shared. Video was shared with media as well as the police at the same time. After this video was published, the pressure was on cops, because the video was on national media. There was immense pressure on the police, and they were quick enough to act and arrest the culprits within 24 hours after the video came to light. So we need to wait and watch how the police are going to take this particular case, because the DGP of Karnataka, who spoke to NewsX yesterday, he went on to say that just for one or two incidents, he cannot increase the patrolling. But if you see in this particular case, again, one more incident has been reported. What will be his answer? Whether he will say that, okay, this is just a third incident, I cannot increase the patrolling, or he will take any kind of action. So it is high time that Karnataka government have to tighten their laces and bring stringent laws and increase patrolling in and around Bengaluru city.
Right. We are through... we're throwing our phone lines open and we're asking people to join in with their reactions. Abha Singh, who's been speaking very strongly on issues like these, is also with us on the phone line. Abha Singh, your first reaction, close to where the Kammanahali incident happened. This is a separate police station area, but this is in Bengaluru, a similar incident taking place within days and even after the police arrested four people.
Yeah. I am happy that people are sending the videos. At least it's a slap on the face of the police of Bengaluru who were saying that nothing happened on 31st. At least these videos are evidence to show that molestation and crime against women in Bengaluru is on the rise and police has not been doing anything. However, not only registering an FIR is the issue, which would be registered under 354, 354A, and also causing hurt, that is 324 of the IPC. But it is important that the police finds a proper foolproof case so that they are convicted in the court. Because if you arrest a person on public media outcry or public outrage and they are bailed immediately, it gives a very wrong signal that in India you can get away by molesting a woman and it is just a minute's job to get bailed.
It is unfortunate, Abha Singh, that I have to highlight this on national television, but so low has been the level of discourse in cases like this. When we saw the New Year's Eve incidents, there were many in positions of power who said these women were wearing short skirts, that their clothes were not appropriate, that they were westernized. As unfortunate as it sounds, here is a contrast. She was clad from head to toe. Do you think all those people who made those insensitive statements should now come forward and apologize? It's not about a woman's clothes. It's about the mentality of the perpetrator.
Definitely. Abu Azmi, Home Minister of Karnataka, Parmeshwara, should come, apologize. They should be made to eat their words. I am appalled that their party heads have not taken any action against them, have not even issued a warning to them. And when everybody knows that crime is an offense under the IPC, by linking it to clothes and Western culture, you are trivializing a serious offense and you are also emboldening to the perpetrators of crime that you commit crime with impunity and blame it on the women. So I think not only taking action against them, but even the Election Commission should take a note and issue guidelines that people in politics and MLAs, MPs should desist from making such statements.
Abha Singh, you understand law better than a lot of other people, and we heard from the Karnataka police chief yesterday saying that security cannot be stepped up overnight because of one or two such incidents. Do you believe that whatever security is on the ground is proving to be an effective deterrence in cases like this?
Not at all. Had there been a deterrent factor, I'm sure these criminals would have desisted from committing such crimes. And when the police commissioner says he cannot make arrangements, I think then he's not fit to be the police commissioner of Bengaluru. Because when you can give away policemen for VIP security, VIP bandobas, why don't you cut down on the cops in bandobas? Why don't you remove the cops who are in the houses of senior officers doing their house duties and telephone duties? You remove from there and put them for women's security, which is of prime importance. This shows his apathy towards crime of women. This shows that he's only interested in pleasing the political bosses, not interested in law and order. I would definitely not agree with him. He cannot. It is the job of the police to provide security. It 149 of the CRPC very clearly says that
right.
Any offense has to be prevented. It is the duty of the police to prevent a crime from happening, and if he's unable to prevent, he must step down or he must be removed from his post.
And if they take cognizance of the offense, the Karnataka police unfortunately was living in denial for the longest time before they moved in to detain and arrest a few people. Our first caller this evening is from Hyderabad. BSN Murthy is with us. Good evening, BSN Murthy.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Madam, what I feel, it is irrelevant, madam. Police or political parties or government cannot do anything, madam. They have, women have to take up. No, they have to stand up on their own. They have to take up some arms with them. Otherwise, they cannot be safe in anywhere in the world, in India.
Well, why do we then pay taxes to support a huge police force is also the question. But I appreciate the point you're making here, Mr. Murthy. Thanks very much for calling us. I believe we have one more caller from Hyderabad. Shankar Chatterjee is with us.
Hello, good evening. It is shameful that every day it is happening. Bangalore is coming in the news in the bad way. Now Bangalore is not in good in the book of the world. So I'm really, as a Indian, I'm feeling shameful for such incident. If government cannot do, let CRPF people, they come. They should invite CRPF people. Or local persons should come together and form a group, civic force like that. And such type of criminal incident must be nipped in the bud. It is shameful for Indians. When we perform puja for matas, Kali Mata, Durga Mata, and women's are mata, sisters are affected,
right.
It feels shameful. It is most shameful. Highly deplorable incidents happening in the Karnataka state, which is considered as a developed state. So
right.
Government should take immediately some action. Who should not be considered at all? Should we have to strongly,
sure.
They should be tackled.
Sure, Mr. Chatterjee, thanks very much. It's not just about Bengaluru. On one side of our screen, we're also looking at images from Delhi. Abba Singh, if you're still with us, the apathy of the onlookers is also something that we've been highlighting, and this seems to be irrespective of which city we are talking about. People don't feel confident enough. People are insensitive. People don't want to step forward to help a woman in distress. We'll try and reconnect with Abba Singh, but this is the unfortunate reality in this country. This is the national capital, unfortunately also called the rape capital of India, where we've seen incidents of assault and crimes against women only on the rise in the past few years, and precious little has changed. We've all talked about an effective law, a stronger law, but the question also arises whether it's being enforced, whether those who think about indulging in such activities have the fear of the law, and that's something that's very, very important when it comes to law enforcement, when it comes to keeping law and order. In fact, this is what happened with a Delhi University professor earlier today, and the CCTV images truly shocking. This professor was assaulted by a goon in full public view in broad daylight in the national capital. And not one of the many, many people who were standing there, the staff of the petrol station and the customers who lined up there, many people drove past them, many people rode past them, not one of them came forward to stop this man who was assaulting the woman.
और पेट्रोल डलवा के गाड़ी में बैठ रही थी तो दूसरी तरफ से गलत डायरेक्शन से उल्टी तरफ से एक तेजी से एक स्कूटी बॉर्न एक आदमी आया जिसका चेहरा अपने जैकेट के कूट से कवर्ड था और वो मुझे और मेरी बैग के खींचते हुए आगे निकल गया तो मैं उस अपने बैग को पकड़ के खड़ी रही तो मैं भी गिरी और उस और मेरा बैग को मैं पकड़ती रही तो मैं गिरी और जिससे वो स्कूटी बाउंड आदमी था वो भी गिरा उसके बाद उसने गाली गलौज शुरू की और मैंने उसका प्रतिरोध किया
वो मैम ने पेट्रोल लिया है उन्होंने गेट खोला अपना उधर से स्कूटी वाला आया रॉन्ग साइड उसने टकराव हुआ आपस में बाकी ऐसा कुछ नजर नहीं आ रहा बैग छीना ऐसा कुछ नजर नहीं आ रहा फुटेज देखकर
लेकिन मारपीट हुई
हाँ मारपीट हुई है वो गलत हुई है मारपीट नहीं करनी चाहिए थी उस लड़के को भी वो गलत किया
पेट्रोल पंप में कई लोग उस वक्त मौजूद थे किसी ने मदद नहीं की इस महिला की अगर हाथ उठा रहा था मारपीट हो रही थी किसी को रोका नहीं लोग देखते रहे
नहीं मैम जब सब कुछ हो चुका जैसे पब्लिक पहुंची है उसके पास इतने में वो निकल गया दो तीन मिनट का खेला हुआ है पब्लिक को भी समझने में टाइम लगता है क्या बात है एकदम हाथ तो कोई डालता नहीं
Former UP DGP Vikram Singh also joining us on the phone line. Dr. Singh, these images from Delhi are truly shocking, sir. Not a single person came forward. We've been speaking to many people ever since these images came to light, and many of them pointed out that people don't feel confident. They feel if they intervene in a case like this, they will be harassed by police in return.
Very disturbing indeed. And such incidents need to be condemned in the harshest words. Now, I would say there seems to be an element of a free-for-all for roadside Romeos and these molesters because the police have not come down with an iron fist on them. The time has come to ensure a drive against all these persons, the molesters, the Romeos, and the Galika Gundas. And these operations are a regular feature in any police SOP. It is not that I'm suggesting something that is something unique. It should happen at least thrice a year, and they should be rounded up, a documentation be made. And those who are supposed to be mute bystanders, helpless bystanders, I have only advice, I do not expect you to get the gallantry medal posthumously, but I certainly would expect to dial 100, to obstruct, to shout, to yell, to pelt stones, to do something to obstruct the escape of the accused. This is the least you can do. Because when you are in distress, you would also be expecting some kind of an assistance or intervention by those around you.
Absolutely. Absolutely, sir. And on the other side of the screen, sir, we are looking at images from Bengaluru. You've headed the police force in one of the most challenging states in India, Uttar Pradesh. Yesterday, we heard from the Karnataka DGP and the Karnataka Police Commissioner also coming out and saying that security cannot be stepped up overnight because of one-off case, as we saw on MG Road and Brigade Road. Can the police get away with statements like these?
Loose argument. If security cannot be stepped at the press of a button, it's no security, and the police force and the leadership should be ashamed of themselves. Security has to be foolproof, invincible, and what is supposed not only foolproof but fail-proof. I can agree that you cannot be present everywhere, but the security cover that you provide has to be everywhere. The terror of the law has to pervade the mind of every criminal or a potential criminal. And if there is a crime, it should not happen. And if it does happen, please get after the jewelers and finish their lives and careers in crime. If you're not able to do it, you will talk the way the police commissioner and the DGP Karnataka are talking.
Would you agree, sir, Dr. Singh, that statements like these from people in positions of power only embolden molesters?
Very true. It emboldens the molesters. It brings down the morale of the common people and also that of our women and girls whom we have failed many times. What impression will they have if the head of the police force says we cannot up the security, we cannot give you security cover, it doesn't happen overnight? What are you donning the uniform for? And if you are unequal to the task expected of your uniform, then give this opportunity to somebody else who is more professional.
The Karnataka police, sir, also said that women have made statements to various media outlets, to television stations, and that is not going to get them justice. They should come to the police and cooperate with the police. Is the police giving them enough reason to feel emboldened, to feel comfortable with sharing their ordeal?
Not in the least. By taking pot shots at the victims of the crime, and has there been anything reassuring on your part? Have you been proactive? Have you been sympathetic? Have you had any sense of shame? You would have been proactive. Your left hand would not have known what the right is doing. And some sensible, some compassionate, some empathetic lady police officer would have gone and spoken to the victim at a place and ensuring total anonymity of the victim. But this has not happened. Here you have flamboyant statements coming that you are speaking to the media. What reassuring conduct have you displayed to get an absolute support and trust of the victim? Absolutely. Obviously, you have done nothing.
Absolutely. I'm going to request you to stay with us. We have Aarti joining us from Bhubaneswar and Mahendra with us from Bengaluru. Good evening to both of you. Aarti, to you first.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I wanted to say Prime Minister Modi has been advocating Beti Bachao, Beti Badhao. So how do Beti kaise badhaye?
Fair point there. Mahendra is also with us from Bengaluru.
Hello, ma'am. Good evening.
Good evening.
The only way how we can go about in fixing this is stringent laws is number one. Number two, I have a question to the police. What if I see a vehicle without a number plate, three Romeos doing wheelies and swirling around? How do we get these guys to the task?
Absolutely. Sagai Raj, my colleague, is also with us live from Bengaluru. Sagai, what has been the initial reaction of the police? Sagai Raj, if you can hear my voice, has the Bengaluru police responded effectively to this new case that has now emerged? We'll try and reconnect with Sagai Raj in just a bit. We are taking a short... Good evening. Welcome to Spotlight. We are highlighting a new set of images that has come in from Bengaluru of a girl on her way to college being stalked and molested by a man. This happened near Kammanahali in Bengaluru, and this too was caught on CCTV. The other set of images is from New Delhi, where a woman was attacked, assaulted by a man in broad daylight, in full public view, with many people, more than a dozen at least, standing by and watching, not one of them coming to her aid, not one of them stopping this man, who then rode away on his bike. Sagai Raj is with us from Bengaluru, my colleague Sagai. How has the Bangalore police responded to this latest incident that has come to light?
The Bangalore police was quick to take action. In fact, initially this victim was reluctant to file any kind of police case, and she was hiding behind the screen. Once this visual was published on social media and mainstream media...
I'm going to interrupt you there, Sagai Raj. I'll come to you. I do apologize for that. Lalita Kumaramangalam, Chief of the National Commission for Women, with us on the phone line. Ma'am, your first reaction, images from Bengaluru and Delhi. It is not about one city, it is about the mindset, and that has become amply clear now.
Yes, it's also about the inability, seeming inability of the police to actually protect our women. I think in this case in Bangalore also, they refused to file the FIR initially till the victim had the courage to come back a second time with some other people with her. Now, our police really need reforms. Along with that, we need to give them serious and consistent and continuous orientation towards, their duty towards protection of women, and also not to be so gender biased. Police also have the same mindset that too many men in this country have, where they lack respect for women and they think women are just objects to be, misused and abused, etc. And that really needs to go. We also need to teach more women what their rights are. There is a concept called the zero FIR, where FIRs can be filed at any police station regardless of where and what crime has taken place, but most women are not aware of that. Also, if the police refuse to file an FIR, they can be punished, they can be held accountable. The thing is, we don't. We seem to have a lot of chips on our shoulders and are afraid of bringing the people in khaki to boot. To make them more accountable. And we need to be, I think we need to make our girls more aware and more courageous. I commend the courage of this girl, of this lady who stood up for her rights. And I hope that, any woman, every woman sooner or later in this country will have the courage to fight back. But the principal thing here is that we need to change our mindset. Every time we have people, VIPs or people in public life, who spout these inanities and all this nonsense that they talk about, where they say, oh, the women were Western, where they were drinking, where they were out at the wrong time of the day, they dressed wrongly, etc. They almost encourage criminals to treat women badly. And that must change. We must, as a society, condemn these people. And I'd also like to say that, when we ask for votes as politicians and as women, I think women should now learn to vote for those who actually will protect them. We are almost 50% of the population, and we make the difference in several states of whether one is going to come to power or not. We need to exercise that. We need to ask and demand what is our right, not be at the mercy of such criminals.
Absolutely. One word, madam, on the role of the people who stand and watch and do not help, as we've seen in this case in Delhi.
That's also part of the mindset, and it's not just her. It's happening all over the country. It's not just Delhi. It's happening all over the country. We had a girl who was hacked to death in Madras, in Chennai. We have people who do the same thing in Delhi. You remember what happened to poor Nirbhaya when she lay bleeding to death almost on the road in Delhi a few years back. This is also what I'm saying, the mindset that we don't respect women. We do not want to put ourselves out for anybody else.
Right.
And today there is a law which actually protects the whistleblowers and the Good Samaritans. Even then, we don't want to do anything for anybody else. Why have we become so selfish? That seems to be part now of our mentality, that we don't want to do anything for anybody else. We don't want to put ourselves out. We don't want to be inconvenienced, etc. We, all of us, really need to step back and, look at ourselves.
Absolutely.
Really look at ourselves deeply and understand that we can't move forward as a country if our society is going to become so degenerate.
Absolutely, ma'am. Thanks very much for your time and for sharing your thoughts with us. We have two more callers before we wrap up the show, both of them from Bengaluru, Murli and Jagdish. Good evening to both of you. Murli, let's come to you first.
Good evening. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening. Hello?
Yes.
See, the point, I'm trying to make is, after the Nirbhaya case in 2012, in a city like Bangalore, where it's a cosmopolitan nature and lot of people from other parts of the country, parts of the world, keep traveling, coming for livelihood, I think we should have, a central women's police station or a state women's police station where, a girl or a lady or a woman is comfortable going and talking. because okay. I think that is missing today. Okay. Otherwise, what happens, you know, as a lady, somebody might be, you know, anybody, I mean, as a who is traumatized or anything, it should not happen.
Sure.
But if it has happened to top also, I think the media should highlight this, where the ladies' police station, where they can take it.
Okay, we've got your point. Let me quickly come to Jagdish as well. We have to wrap the show. Jagdish?
Yeah. Ma'am, good evening. The point I'm trying to make here is, it is very, very important that the local police understands protecting the interest of the whistleblower. That law has not sunk in very well. And they have an app called as Public Eye. Huh. In that Public Eye, you have to declare all your identity and where one does not feel very safe. Plus, there are very few lovely pockets in Bangalore where these Romeos go about on all the two-wheelers without a number plate. I have recorded a couple of them, but how do you go about in raising them if they don't have a number plate? And they say it's not our job. RCU has to look into the number plate issue. So it's a chicken and the egg story. Today, this is a very...
Right, very pertinent issues being raised by people who live in Bengaluru, and we are asking you to keep coming in with your suggestions, with your thoughts on something that is a matter of urgent importance for all of us, really. We're going to